I'm going to show another way that you can make a baby booty. Again, I'm going to be grafting this first row to itself. I need to start out with live stitches, so I worked up, I don't know how many rows of waste yarn, one row of ravel cord, which I put on these bobbins. Then with the main yarn, and the carriage was on the left, it doesn't matter if it's on the left or the right, but I knitted one row. I am going to put my carriage to hold. In this case, I'm putting the front Russell levers forward to the one. Then I am going to take all the needles left of zero, but I want to take right one as well into holding position. Actually, I'm going to take two more needles because I want to automatic wrap so there's no holes there. Nope, just two needles. So I keep the third needle into work. I'm going to push that needle back so it wraps. This time I'm going to take two needles and push those back into the forward working position. Take the last needle and knit it out, put it out to holding position. So that would be four rows. I don't have my counter going. Now I want to work over to the left here. So I take the left side of my carriage off a hold. I knit across. I make sure I put my carriage back to hold. Now I'm going to take all the needles right of zero and two on the left one and left two. I'm going to knit across. No, I'm sorry, just to left one. Now I'm bringing left two out to hold. That was knitted. Go back. I'm going to take the next two needles from hold, put them into the forward working position, knit back to the right, put the last stitch that was knitted back to holding position, and then go back to the left. Now that was four rows on each side, so I could go ahead and put four on my counter and set my tripper so it's going to count. Now I'm going to knit three more rows. Then I want to take 12 stitches opposite the carriage, and I'm going to take them off and put them on my long circular needle here. Then I'm going to pull that needle so that the stitches are on the middle part of that. I'm going to knit back to the left. I'm going to take the opposite end, and I'm going to do the same with 12 needles over here. Again, pulling that needle through so that they're pretty much like crossing each other. And actually, with the last stitch, I probably should have just left it on the hook, because now what I want to do is I want to take one stitch opposite the carriage off of the circular needle and put it on the end needle. I have nine needles in work here. Knit across. And I'm going to stop the counter. That was at 7. Then I'm going to take the next stitch off of the cable, off of the cable, and put it on the needle. Now you want to make sure that this needle is not going up, or you're going to jam your carriage, and the knitting goddess is going to be so mad. Of course, you may end up ruining your carriage as well. So I'm just going to go back and forth. Of inserting one needle opposite the carriage, I'm sorry, one stitch from the circular needle onto the end needle and work. And I probably don't need my cast on comb anymore, and I will eventually take it off and I will put claw weights here. And here is a close-up of what I am doing. I'm just taking my one-prong tool, slipping it through that stitch on the needle, and hanging it on the end needle. Pulling my needle back, knit across, and then I go to the opposite side. Now I do that until I have 6 stitches left on my needle. If you don't have a circular needle, just do it with waste yarn. Fold the waste yarn back is all. And I do have the 2 stitches on there. But now what I want to do is I want to hang these 6 stitches onto the next needles. Again, opposite the carriage, so it will knit that one. But also, because I don't want to have a hole over here, what I am going to do is take the purl bump, if I can get it, from the circular needle here. I'm going to take that purl bump from the row before and just hang it on that needle for now. And that's going to close up any holes that would happen. Now, if I was to have one here, which, yeah, looks like I may, I would take the purl bump from the row before on the next needle and just hang it on that needle. So knit across. Then I'm going to take these 6 stitches and hang them on the opposite side. Now, I do need to put claw weights on the ends here. And if I did not grab that purl bump stitch from before, I would just do it here is all. Now I'm going to knit back. And I am going to put my counter tripper back on. But now, because I've found that sometimes if I don't short row a few rows here, this part of it's going to go on an angle, kind of like that. So anyways, I'm setting my carriage for a hold again. Then I'm going to take I don't want to go that far. So I'm 2 needles onto the what is the top of the foot. I knit across. I bring the last stitch that was knitted into holding position, knit back. I knit across again. I take the last stitch that was knitted, knit back. So there's four rows I did on that side. Now I need to get the carriage over here. I take the carriage off a hold, and I'm going to do the same on the opposite side. So it was two needles into the work there. I did one more needle than I should have. Let's see. Yeah, so it should have been from right three over. So again, I take that last needle that was knitted, bring it forward so it's going to wrap, knit back, oops, oh no, that's right, bring that last needle knitted into hold so it wraps. That's the four rows. Now I'm going to take my carriage off a hold, and then I'm going to knit, well, I have the counter on there now. I did four rows, so I want to do seven more rows. Actually, I'm going to do six, and then I am going to put my carriage up to tension dial 10 because I am on tension dial 4 with this yarn. If not, just bring the needles forward and hand knit that last row so the stitches are larger. Then I go ahead and bring my needles to hold in position, take my weights off. I'm going to bind off on the top of this. Watch out for those gate pegs. I am going to graft the bottom row to itself and then sew up the back seam. And this is what you get when you're finished. Now, if you don't do the short rows here, what's going to happen is the bootie's just going to be on an angle is all. But when you put it on the baby, it's going to work out just right. So it's really up to you. I just like to do that little extra step myself.